Now, our cat function isn't very smart. It makes the same cat every single time. I'm going to refactor it a bit so we can make all kinds of cats. Now, right now, when you call to make a new cat, it just runs this function and does all of this stuff. But we're not passing anything into it. Let's pass an object literal into our cat constructor function. I'm going to call it data. Now, if someone gave us, say, an array of cat data, we could easily make those different cats by saying new cat and passing an object literal. See, thinking ahead is good. Now let's go through the steps to make this work. Now before we tackle this part here, let's tackle what gets passed in. Down here, when I say new cat, I'm gonna pass in that object literal. Later on, we'll actually have multiple cats, so we'll be doing this again and again and again for each cat object. Now here are the various properties for the same cat that our cat function up above was making over and over again. Now we're passing them into the cat constructor function. Now up at the top, instead of actually setting these values like this, we're gonna actually set them based on the data that gets passed in. So this.clickCount will actually be equal to data.clickCount. From the object literal that we passed down below into here, we'll set the click count of that to the cat that we're creating. We'll do the same thing for all the rest of them. Now this.title stays exactly the same, because for every cat, if the clicks are less than 10, the title will be newborn. Less than 50 is infant, etc. That's hard-coded into the cat. And now, rather than having our data actually explicitly set here, we're setting the data down here where we create these cats. Now we're ready for more cats. Let's add them in the next video.